We read in Proverbs and chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, again, promise of God for those who trust the Lord. Proverbs 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths or make your paths straight. So again, we are to trust in the Lord with all of our heart. We looked at the heart a couple of weeks ago and looked at, I think it was last Sunday, and all that the Bible has to say about our heart. So God is saying he wants our whole heart. He wants it all. He says, trust in the Lord with your whole heart, with all your heart. Do not get caught up in your head. Don't lean on your own understanding, because some things we just can't figure out. God says, my ways are higher than your ways, as the heavens are higher than the earth. So my ways are higher and my thoughts are higher than your ways. There's just things we can't possibly comprehend that God is doing, but we have to trust him. So we just rest in our trust in the Lord. We don't get caught up in our own understanding trying to figure everything out, because some things we won't be able to figure out till after they happen. And then he tells us, in all your ways, acknowledge him. In all your ways, acknowledge him. So that means everywhere you go, acknowledge the Lord. Let people know you're a Christian. Don't be ashamed of your faith. Invite people to church. Tell people about our services. Tell people about our YouTube channel and our Facebook page. There's so many people here because you saw us on Facebook or YouTube or one of those social media platforms that I despise so much, really. I don't like social media. Many people know that. But God uses it anyways. And you're here as a result. And so there's tons of people out there that are hurting, that are lost, that are lonely. And they need hope. They need encouragement. This is one of the things that Pastor Mike McClure told me about when they reopened their church, in spite of all of the fines and the threats to go to prison and jail and all the rest, is he says that they had someone who was trying to come to church. I don't know if it was his church or a friend of his down the street, but this individual wanted to come to church. The church was closed. She was suffering from depression, and she ended up committing suicide. And so he said once he heard that, he just thought, it doesn't really matter what price I have to pay or what it costs me. We need to have the church doors open right now because people are hurting. People are broken. People are lonely. People need hope. And where are they going to find it? On the internet? They're going to find it on social media? I don't think so. So we need to have the church doors open because people right now need the Lord more than ever before. And so we need to let our light shine, and we need to acknowledge the Lord everywhere we go, and then the Lord will direct our paths. Again, speaking of the way of the Lord and the way of life and the way of wisdom for the child of God, in Proverbs chapter 10, here's just a few of the Proverbs for you, for things to think on, meditate on. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 17 says this, he who keeps instruction is in the way of life, but he who refuses correction goes astray. Seems pretty basic. If you are listening to instruction and you're obeying what God is instructing you to do, then you are going to be fine. You're going to be on the way that leads to life. But if you refuse correction, you're going to go astray. So again, the choice is yours, the choice is mine. Am I going to obey or disobey what the Lord tells me to do? In verse 27, Proverbs 10, 27, the fear of the Lord prolongs days, but the years of the wicked will be shortened. The fear of the Lord is a good thing. It's good to fear God. I tell people I fear God. There's just things I won't do because I fear God, because I really do fear God, because I don't want to, you know, he's holy and he's righteous and he's all powerful, and I'm not presumptuous to think that I can do things which I know are wrong and somehow it's going to be okay. I fear the Lord. And the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And the fear of the Lord will prolong your days, but the years of the wicked will be shortened. Verse 29, the way of the Lord is strength for the upright, but destruction will come to the workers of iniquity. So if you want to walk in the way of the Lord, there will be strength for you, for the upright. The Bible promises. In Proverbs chapter 11 and verse 3, Solomon says this, the integrity of the upright will guide them, but the perversity of the unfaithful will destroy them. So if you have integrity, if you're integrous in how you live your life, if you're seeking to be above reproach, you're seeking to be a real Christian, like letting your light shine, not being ashamed, not hiding your light and being ashamed of your faith in Jesus Christ, but letting it shine, whatever the consequences, whatever the cost, he says, the integrity of the upright will guide them. Again, it's kind of like acknowledging the Lord in all your ways, and then he will direct your paths. But perversity, man, we live in such a perverse culture today. The perversity of the unfaithful will destroy them. Verse 9 says this, the hypocrite with his mouth destroys his neighbor, but through knowledge the righteous will be delivered. So the hypocrite is the one who's gossiping and slandering and always bad-mouthing people and talking about his neighbor, trying to destroy his neighbor. Verse 14 says, where there is no counsel, the people fail or fall, but in the multitude of counselors there is safety. None of us is an island unto ourselves. We need each other. We need counsel. We need wise counsel, and we need encouragement, and we need prayer. Verse 17, Proverbs 11, the merciful man does good for his own soul, but he who is cruel troubles his own flesh. The merciful man does good for his own soul. Jesus said, you know, the one who's merciful will find mercy. Matthew chapter 5, the Sermon on the Mount, the Beatitudes, the merciful man. And so this is a way that you, if you want mercy and you want goodness in your life, then you should be a merciful person. If you are a merciful man, a merciful woman, you're doing good to yourself. But he who is cruel does trouble to himself. He troubles his own flesh. Verse 19, as righteousness leads to life, so he who pursues evil pursues it to his own death. Don't you see that there's choice, choice, choice? God gives us free will. He gives us choice. He's sovereign. He knows the future. He knows everything, every choice you're going to make. He knows the end from the beginning. But he still wants us to choose life, to choose to obey him.